condemnation. No judgment.
Yes.
If you ever watch Law and Order or any particular series that's pertaining to the law, every defendant wants to hear not guilty.
Come on, talk good now.
We, as members of the body, need to know, since we have become members of his kingdom, that there is deliverance and redemption.
Oh, yes.
We are free from struggling with the spirit of sin. Mm-hmm. Because if we're lost in this world, there are oppositional forces that face us.
Yes, sir.
But when we become members of the body, the same oppositional forces that face us, we now have freedom through Jesus Christ.
Amen. Oh, yes.
Paul, in Romans chapter 8, lets us know that we can be free from struggling and suffering, but we only are free by the Spirit of God.
Oh, yes.
This whole chapter, when you have time, you need to read it and concentrate on it. The Bible says in verse 1, there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus. Notice what he says. Who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
After the Spirit?
When we're lost in our sins, we walk and do basically what the flesh wants to do.
Oh, yes.
Because our minds have not been transformed by the Word of God.
Oh, yes.
Since Christ has come, Romans 3, verses 21 and 22, we know the Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Oh, yes.
We know that. We know that we each have an eternal destiny.
Oh, yes.
We each need to know that even the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ, unto all and upon all them that believe, but there is no difference. I'm glad that Paul was guided by the Holy Spirit.
Oh, yes.
Because he says there is no difference. On Friday, at the presidential inauguration, there were protests all over this country.
Oh, yes.
By women and men, stating their claim of being not treated fairly.
Yes, sir.
Even at that, at the end of the day, Donald Trump is still president.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But we as children of God need to know that there is a greater, higher power.
Oh, yes.
There is one who looks high looks low.
Oh, yes.
There is one who, in the beginning, God created the world, man, and everything was good. Mm-hmm. So when I hear Mr. Trump say, make America great again,
come on, talk to
him. America is already great.
Amen.
Because it was created by someone that spoke and nothing became something.
Oh, yes.
It was created by someone who touched and something moved.
Oh, yes.
It was created by someone who hears, sees, and knows everything.
Oh, yes.
It was created by God the Father. It was created by someone who has all power in his hand.
Oh, yes.
As we delve up into this text this morning, I want to give you 3 points, but I won't get to all 3 points. The first point is, now since Christ has come, Romans 3, 21 and 22, the believer is not condemned. Why? It's because we are in Christ Jesus. The second point is, the Spirit gives life by freeing the believer from sin and death, also by doing what the law could not do. We also need to look at the spiritual. The Spirit pulls the mind to spiritual things. The carnal mind versus the spiritual mind.
Yes.
the fate of both men's, the fate of both minds, mm-hmm. is a destiny that versus life and peace and also versus death. We need to look at the reason. The carnal mind dwells in man. We won't get to those 3 points. What I want to concentrate on this morning is verse number 1. There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Good to see Kevon come in this morning. Good to see Brother Kenneth come in.
Amen.
We need to know and understand. This refers to man's justification, defined negatively as a state wherein there is no condemnation. The ground of justification is the perfect righteousness in Christ Jesus. No condemnation means that when we become believers in the body of Christ, which is the church of Christ, it means that we are not doomed.
Oh, yes.
We are not damned, but we're free from the penalty and condemnation of sin. We are not judged as a sinner,
amen.
But we are delivered from the condemnation, of death and hell. We are not judged, but we are counted as righteousness.
Come on, brother, come on.
We are not unrighteous, but we are counted as righteousness. Uh-huh. In the sight of God. Brother Berto, it's good to see you this morning. I'm going to work you while you're visiting with me this morning. Give me Galatians chapter 5.
Amen.
If you will give me Galatians chapter 5, I want you to start about verse number 15. And I want you to come down. We need to find out why we are lost and trapped in sin. We need to find out why we have such a hard time, even prior to us coming into the body of Christ.
Oh, yes.
And even when we get into the body of Christ. What does the Bible say? Begin with verse number 15, if you will, Brother Berto.
See then that ye walk, Christendom, not as fools, but as wise.
We walk not as fools. Some of us have come into the body of Christ and we're still walking in a foolish manner.
Amen.
We have not become wise because we have not taken it upon ourselves to study, yes. to show ourselves approved workmen that needed not to be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of truth. Read on for me, Brother Berto.
Redeeming the time.
Read, yes.
Because the days are evil.
Read.
Therefore, be ye not unwise.
But
Understanding that.
Be understanding.
That the will of God is.
That my will.
Yes, sir.
That my will.
Mm-hmm.
That they say that, Brother Bertie. You got to listen to me. That my will. What does the Bible say? That my will.
But understanding that the will of the Lord is.
The will of the Lord is what?
Is. The will of the Lord is.
The will of the Lord is. Read on for me.
And be not drunken.
Be not drunken.
With wine.
With wine. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody said, well, it's okay to just take a little bit of wine.
Amen.
Let me give you a little bit of history. Back in the times when they were drinking wine, it was for medicinal purposes. Amen, somebody.
Yes.
And then you would mix that wine with what? A little water. Amen, somebody. So, preach, Brother Norris. Read on for me, Brother Berto. We're going to get through this. Read on.
There is in excess. In excess.
Yes.
But be filled with the Spirit.
But be filled with the Spirit.
Yeah.
So what Paul says, very simply stated, the person who is now in Christ Jesus
Man.
Is safe and secure yeah. from condemnation now and forever. How can I be safe from condemnation now and forever? First of all, I need to have a prayer life that's going to be prevalent in my life, and it has to be on a day-to-day basis. First Corinthians 15, verse number 58. Don't go there. You stay where you are. The Bible says, be ye steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the kingdom. So this is what's going to keep me now, and it's going to keep me forever. So I need to know that I won't be judged as a sinner. I will not face condemnation. It is beyond condemnation. He shall never be condemned for his sin. Yes. He shall never be separated from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Notice the Bible starts out with this particular chapter. Yes. Starts out with condemnation, and it ends with no separation. Amen, somebody. Amen. If I'm not condemned, that means I'll never be separated from God, my Father.
Oh, yes.
Because of sin, nothing shall separate me.
Oh,
nor
yes.
Family, nor anything shall separate me
oh, yes.
from the love of God.
Oh, yes.
We're talking about the power of the Spirit this morning.
Yes.
Even in our lives, we have trouble
yes.
on top of trouble.
Yes,
we need to know that there is a greater source.
Yes.
We need to know that we have prayer.
Yes.
That's our greatest weapon.
Oh, yes.
We need to always pray to God that He will deliver us. Some of us aren't getting the blessings that God has for us because we aren't praying.
No.
Amen, somebody. When we come into the body of Christ, we need to learn how to pray. Our Father teaches us how to pray. He says, when you pray, pray our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy holy name. We need to know that His name is holy. We need to know that He knows our every care and our every need. We need to know that He has already been where we are. And we need to know that He will deliver us. We're free from the condemnation. John chapter 3. Verse number 16, the Bible says, for God so loved the world. I like that. He loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. How can I get this everlasting life, Brother Norris? How can I know that I have no condemnation? I can get this everlasting life because my mind is now transformed yes. by the Word of God.
Amen.
Romans 12, verse number 1, the Bible said, I beseech you. In other words, Paul said, I beg you that you present your body a living sacrifice. In other words, my body is now holy and divine. It now belongs to God. I may have tattoos. Amen, somebody. That was before I came into the body, but now I'm spiritually tattooed with the Word of God. That's the reason we can't knock anybody, because all of us have some worldly tattoos. They may not be physical, but some of our tattoos are mentally. Amen, somebody. And we never get beyond our worldly tattoos. Some of us still drink in excess. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. Some of us still smoke some things that we shouldn't be smoking. Amen, Brother Norris. Some of us still are sleeping with some people that are not our husband or not our wife. Some of us are still saying some things that we should not say. I'm talking about living by the Spirit's power. I'm not talking about living by Satan's power. Some of us are doing some things that we should not be doing. That's the reason we probably late on Sunday morning, because we had to get a few extra hours of sleep because we went out last night. Amen, Brother Norris. It's okay to go out. As long as you're going out in Jesus. Amen. See, I've been there. I know what it means to go out. Roberto, I know what it means to leave home at 11 o'clock at night and not come back. Amen. Amen. Not come back until the sun rises. But I was told, don't nothing happen. Anytime you're out all night, something ain't good for you. I'm not going to say what's open, because I'm preaching. Amen, somebody. I'm just being real with you.
Amen.
Amen. We need to know that we're living by the Spirit's power.
Yes.
We're not condemned anymore because we are in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Now, I want somebody else to give me Romans chapter 8. Let's start by verse number 33. Let's go down through here and see what Paul is telling us. For the most crucial point, only the believer who is in Christ will not be condemned. Notice he says only those who are in Christ. You got to be in Christ. Brother Norris, what do you mean by being in Christ? Well, I think I got to help you out this morning.
Right.
That is water that I'm drinking this morning. This water is in this bottle. Amen, somebody. When I drink this water, I have to drink from
the bottle.
This bottle. So the more I drink, the less water Amen. Thank you, sister. Let's water. I'm gonna have. So we got to be in Christ Jesus. We're not in Christ Jesus. This does not apply to us, but you have that opportunity this morning as we preach this gospel to help you understand that there is a better way to live than to live in sin. Romans chapter 8, let's start about verse number 33, if you will. Come down. Somebody ought to be in Romans chapter 8. Kendall, what you waiting on? What you waiting on? What you waiting on, Kendall? Come on.
Who shall lay anything
to the charge
of God's elect?
To the charge of God's elect. Read.
It is God that justifies.
It is God that justifies.
Who is he that condemneth?
Who is he that condemneth?
It is Christ.
It is Christ. See, we need to know and understand. Who's the condemner? It's Christ that condemned. Read on for me, Brother Ken.
Yeah, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God.
He's at the right hand of God. Read on for me.
Who also maketh intercession for us.
He maketh intercession. In other words, he's my doctor.
Yes, sir.
In a sick room. He's my lawyer. In the courtroom. He's my mediator. In my own house. Paul told Timothy, there's one mediator between God and man, and that person is Christ Jesus, my Lord and Savior. So now that I am in Christ, now that I have come out of darkness, out of the world, I have now stepped into Christ by confessing the sweetest name on mortal tongue, going down into the watery grave of baptism. When I rose up out that water, Brother Berto, I became a new Christian. I became a new creation in God's kingdom. Perhaps was a drug dealer before I got into the water, but when I came up out of the water, I'm no longer a drug dealer. I'm not going to say I was a prostitute, but now I'm a prostitute, amen somebody. Perhaps there was a prostitute, probably before that person going down into the water, when they came up out of the water, they are now new creatures in Christ Jesus. Then perhaps you were a liar, or a thief, or a beggar man, or whatever you might be, or Indian chief. Whenever you go down into the watery grave of baptism, and you arise out of that water, you become a new creature. And now you are in Christ. Now you have all spiritual blessings that belong to those who are in Christ Jesus. You are now free from your sin. But we have to stay free from our sin. We have to stay free from our sin. We have to stay free. Read on for me, Brother Kim.
Who shall separate us from the love of Christ?
Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Listen to what Paul said.
Shall tribulation. Distress.
I'm not going to get to the point where I get distressed. That I'm going to become separated from God. Amen, somebody. During all of my tribulation and my trials, what are you going to do? Brother Norris, I'm going to continue to pray. What are you going to do? I'm going to continue to pray. I may perhaps even sing a song during my trial. Brother Johnson, I may have to say, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch. Don't tell me that won't bring me up out of my tribulation and my trial. Don't tell me that won't make me feel good during my trial. Don't tell me when oppositional forces are against me that amazing grace will set me free. It'll cause me to see my day a little bit brighter. It'll cause my burden to be just a little bit lighter, because he said in Matthew chapter 11, verse number 28, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. Now that I'm a Christian, Brother Johnson, I know I get heavy laden, because I get heavy laden with the burden of the church. I get heavy laden with members of the church. I get heavy laden because it seems sometimes they aren't listening to the word of God. It seems sometimes that they aren't obedient to the word of God. So Brother Chris, I have to keep holding on to God's unchanging hand. I have to keep pressing toward the mark of the higher calling. I have to keep living in the glory land way. Amen, church. I'm talking about the power of the Holy Spirit. Tribulation. I may have trouble in my home. I may have trouble on my job. There may be trouble in the church. But I know that I can be delivered. Because the Bible says that no tribulation. Read on for me, Brother Kenneth. No tribulation. And what else?
Tenure or distress.
Or distress.
A persecution.
Persecution.
A famine.
Somebody said, Brother Norris, what is persecution? Persecution is something that follows you. It's not going anywhere. James says that we are approached by diverse temptations. Perizimos, they're going to come from everywhere. 9 times out of 10, they come from within the church, Brother Berto. But the greatest tempter comes from within myself. See, when we realize, we go through storms. Sometimes we have to realize that the storm is in us. Amen, somebody. Sometimes we have to realize that the storm is in us. Most of the time, the reason sometimes we can't get out of our storm because we don't want to admit that we're the one that's causing us to be. Amen, somebody. Paul says, nothing shall separate me. Nothing's going to separate me from the love of God. Read on from me, Brother Kenneth.
Or nakedness.
Huh?
Or nakedness.
Nakedness.
Or peril.
Or peril.
Or sword.
Or sword. Don't you let a naked situation, this is not talking about being naked. Don't you let a naked situation cause you to leave God? Just because you're lacking some things? Huh? All spiritual blessings can be found in Jesus Christ. Huh? I may be destitute in money. But Berto, if you're in this kingdom and you got money, that's some of my money. Amen, somebody. Somebody say, no, this is my money. No. This is my brother. He knows I'm in need. We got money. We got money. One sister joined up and said, no, this is my money. No, this is not your money. This is our money.
Yeah.
And my wife and I were somewhere, we were in Ohio, and the brother said, they got money. Yeah. We got money. You got money, I don't have any money, I'm destitute. I'm connected to someone that has money. But what we get in trouble is, I act like I don't know you. Amen. Because you don't have any money. Get your job like I got. Huh? I'm talking about being destitute. Paul said nothing. Come into church as you are. Well, I can't dress like those people. Where do we get this from? Identifying our own kind as those people.
Yeah.
Them folk. I'm part of these folk.
Yes.
Amen. Sister Chris, I'm part of you. I might not look good as you do. I'm not supposed to because you're a woman. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. Help me out, Holy Spirit. But you don't have a right to, I don't have a right to talk about she, you know, she thinks she this. She is. She's a Christian.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Where do we get this from? Not wanting to be identified with our own people. Huh? Paul said destitute. Read on for me, Kenneth. This is not my word. These are the words of Paul.
As
if you got your Bible, this is, Sister Bell, don't you have a Bible? Isn't that in your Bible? Huh? My sister, isn't that in your Bible? Won't you read that same thing? Read that for me again, Brother Kenneth.
As it is written.
As it is written.
For thy sake we are killed all the day long.
For thy sake we are killed. We're murdered all day long, even though we are Christians. But we have Christ Jesus, who is our anchor. And when we become anchored in him, murder me, do what you will. God is going to take care of me. I know I can be delivered. Maybe not in this world, but in the world to come.
That's
you don't want to kill, please.
We are counted as sheep.
We are counted as sheep.
For the slaughter.
For the slaughter.
Nay, in all these things, we are more than
conquerors. Yay! That is in all these things. Do what you want to me. Come on with it. In all these things. God is going to get the glory in all things. What does it say, Ken?
Through him that loved us.
Through him. It's not through my 401k, not through my money, and it's sure not through you. I'm connected to you because you're a child of God. But if your behavior is not becoming as a child of God, I have a right to let you know you are not acting properly.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Sorry.
Through it all.
Sorry,
I still
have
a way.
All right.
I don't know a way. Sit through it all.
Yes.
Ken, you got to go back. That sounds so good. Read that for me again. Verse 37.
Nay, all these things.
In all things, not some things.
We are more than conquerors.
Not some things. In all things.
We are
in
more
all
than
things.
All.
We're more than conquerors.
Through him that loved us.
Through him. John 3:16. He told you he loved you.
Yes,
Matthew 28, he said, I'll be with you, lo, always, even until the end of the world. Don't worry about Donald Trump being in the White House. I don't have to protest.
Amen.
I don't have to protest. Amen. I don't have to hold up a sign saying you're not my president.
Right.
I have to respect you as a president, but God is my high priest.
Amen.
He's today, yesterday, and forevermore. Hebrews 13:8, he doesn't change. The world may change, but God does not change. Church, when you have the power of Jesus, when you're a Christian, you can make it during these struggles. Paul says, those that are in Christ will not be condemned. Then we're going to get to this position. Everybody wants to have a position in the church. Everybody wants to be somebody in the church. It's strange to me how people want to be something, but when it comes time to really be something, like picking up some paper, they don't want to do that. No, they can't be seen doing that. They don't want to be seen driving the van. They don't want to be seen on Sunday night reading the scripture. Amen, Brother Norris. They don't want to be seen praying with somebody that needs prayer.
Come on.
They won't be out front.
Come on.
Their family's out of order. Why tell him what to do? He don't have no kind of say so. He don't stand on nothing. Whichever way the wind blows, that's where he is. But you want to be a leader in the church.
Come on, tell me.
Just back and forth. Somebody ask you something, well, I think that's right. Stand on what's right.
Amen.
And stand strong.
Oh, yes.
I don't care about people talking about me. I know who I am. And I know who I belong to. Say what you will. My works through Jesus Christ is through him that I move, I live, and I have my very existence. And you do too. If you haven't become a member of the church, you need to. Time is moving on. Sister Oliver, I used to talk to that lady at least twice a week. Missed 1 week. The day that I was going to call her was the day that she passed. Are you still in the state of, I'm going to? Huh? I'm about to? We need church. Let's do it!
Amen.
James said, our lives are but vapor that appears for Chuck Wilder, then it's gone. I'm calling and encouraging her. She said, Brother Norris, I know I'm going to die. I said, no. We all going to die. She said, no! I know my time is up. I said, no, sister. All of our time is up. She said, no, Brother Norris, you're not listening. I'm facing death because I know. She said, I know I have an assurance. Can you say that this morning? Can you just say, knowing you're going to die and be glad that you're dying? Be glad that you've been to leave here? And she told me some things. She told me some things about you too. Amen. She told me some things about myself. That it's going to help me. I see you whispering, wonder what did she tell you? You know what she told me. You know what she told me. Yeah, through negative. Girl, nothing.
Yes.
Position. Got mighty quiet. That's all right. I'm going to preach until I die. What does the word in Christ mean?
Yes.
It means that you are in Christ, just like this water. The contents of this water is in this bottle. When I consume all this water, all I have is an empty bottle. When you're in the world, all you have is an empty person. You need to be filled with God's Spirit. It sure will help you. It'll teach you not to cuss. Amen. If you do, you can ask God for forgiveness. It won't be a slip because it's hardly there. Amen. Amen. I talked to a preacher before he was throwing out some prayers. I said, hold on, brother. We need to pray. He was just cussing. I said, hold on. Wait a minute. He said, Brother, what's wrong? I said, we need to pray. He said, Brother, no, you're right. He said, look how the devil has got me. I mean, brother, he was throwing them out there. Those are some of those words that I know I used to use, and you did. Amen. I mean, superlative on top of superlative. This preacher was going at it. Disgusted by what's going on in the brotherhood. I was too. But I wasn't going to let Satan take me like that.
Okay.
Oh, no. I stopped and we prayed. You know, but I prayed that prayer got through. Yes, I know it got through. I haven't seen it. Right. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
I stopped. Time out. Right. Take a spiritual time out. When you are naked, take a spiritual time out. When you are distressed, take a spiritual time out. James said, think.
Yeah.
Before you speak.
Yeah.
Receive with meekness the engrafted word of God, which is able to save your soul. It will make you what Jesus was. They talk about you, but you're still pressing. Amen. I might be naked, but I'm still pressing. I might be in distress, Kendall, but I'm still pressing. I might not have, I don't have no money today. Not visible. But I got some money. Don't we get some money? She named now. You got something. You got things. She know. She said she got some money. She probably saying, I don't want now. I'm going to eat till I die, baby. This is the death do us fall. Amen, somebody. Amen, yeah. I get it from her all the time. That means she looking like that. You gotta explain that. My baby would make me think we're on our way to the divorce court. Oh, no. We're a long way from that. They be going back to get remarried again. They banging somebody. That's what I'm talking about. I love that one. I might not be the best looking, but can't nobody love her like I love her. Amen, somebody. Amen. God gave you one. You better love her to give her everything you got. I'm giving everything I got, Sister Norris. It ain't much, but I'm all I got, baby. I'll be able to get some money when church is over now. Oh, church, I got to bring it to us like that. Because that's where we live. That's where we are, Brother Bear. That's where we are. It's at your door. You get distressed sometimes. You get naked in your spirituality. You're not all that you want to be sometimes. You're not always right. Amen. When discussion going between you and Sister Bear, you're not always right, and she's not always right.
Amen.
But 9 times out of 10, she is.
Right.
Amen. How did I get off on that position? Let me conclude this. Roberto, can you come back next Sunday? Can we pray that you come back next Sunday? I'm talking about this position.
Yes, sir.
We got money. I have some. God bless you. The position is we're all in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
We've all, those of you who have not become part of this fellowship, won't you step out on faith this morning?
Yes.
Give your life to Jesus so you can be like Sister Oliver.
Amen.
Even up to the last minute,
amen,
she had a smile on her face.
Amen.
Because she knew her soul was gone.
Yes.
Some of us get scared when we go to the doctor.
All right.
Amen. Ooh. Well, that's because some of us don't go.
Right.
We don't know. We don't want to find out.
Right.
We forget about our soul. This is going to somebody's graveyard.
Right.
And I told the family yesterday, they said, well, Brother, we want everything to be short. I said, well, this left up to the family, because I'm not going to preach like this Sunday morning. She's already gone.
Amen.
But I am concerned about those.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Where are you this morning?
Amen.
Good to see Sister Gail with us this morning. See how good she looks. She's been sick. Sister Bobby
amen,
here.
Amen.
Got the cane, and don't even need the cane, just in case.
Amen.
Want to bring it to you? Hey, a lot of us have forgot our cane. This is just in case. You need to keep it with you.
Amen.
I know I'm standing, but this is just in case I fall. I know to pick me up.
Yeah.
See, you're a child of God. I know you're going to pick me up. I'm not depending on you. I'm depending on you having faith in God.
Yeah.
If you ain't got no faith, I'm still wanting you to pick me up.
Amen.
Because we both need to be strengthened.
Yeah.
God told Peter, when you are converted, now you strengthen your brother.
Amen.
Sister Gail is here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Where are you this morning? Suppose death rained at your door and it hit you. Are you going to die?
Come on, brother.
Oh, yeah.
You going to die? Okay, how much makeup you put? Okay, how much you work out, you going to die?
Amen.
The director said yesterday, he said, Sister Oliver was a woman of her word.
Amen.
And she told Mrs. Daniels, I get so quiet on the phone, she said, Brother, are you there? Yes, I'm here. What do you want me to say? What can I say but thank you?
Yes, sir.
I thank that woman.
Amen.
Never met her face to face. Talked to her on the phone. Thanked her.
Mm-hmm.
Talked to me like she'd been knowing me all my life. She said, you're a gospel preacher. I know.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm telling you is true.
Mm-hmm.
She said, don't you let the devil.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been calling the devil.
Mm-hmm.
But that's all right. That's all right.
Mm-hmm.
The power of the Spirit. Each one, teach one. However be it be in your life, your manner. See, when we get beside the point, when we get out of this mentality that I'm not perfect, stop letting people talk about the church because they're talking about you. No, we're not perfect, but we're in the hands of a perfect God.
Yes.
He's the one that holds all power. When you're in distress and you're in your moment of nakedness, and you just get so down and you think you don't know what to do, you get on your knees and pray. Yes. You may have to cry. You ain't gonna cry always all the time. Yes. Cry until you cry your heart out. My Lord and Savior wept when his friend Lazarus died. But he stopped crying because joy came, because he knew what Lazarus' soul was. Yes. Resting in the arms of Jesus. Yes. Oh, we need him this morning. Don't you want him this morning?
Yes.
Don't you want him to clean your life up? Oh, you got everything now. You got your pretty smile. You got your figure.
Yes, sir.
You don't need any air. You don't take any pills for high blood pressure. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
As the director told me yesterday, he said, just keep waking up.
Yes.
Just keep waking up.
Yes.
Just keep waking up. It's going to happen to you.
Yes.
Young people, you need Jesus.
Amen.
Young girl, keep yourself. Don't you let no little boy destroy you. Because he going to get you pregnant. He's going to go on about his business.
Amen.
He's not going to be there.
No.
When the time when you need him, you keep yourself, get your education.
Yes.
And get you some Jesus. You go a long way.
Amen.
I know. Church, I pray God these words will help you.
Yes.
Yes.
Let's continue to let the Spirit of God motivate us.
Yes.
Let's let the Spirit of God work in our lives.
Yes.
I guarantee you. Because the word I got yesterday, this is from the undertaker. He knows.
Yes.
Everything comes right there to the funeral home.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And he's from Palestine.
Mm-hmm.
Another faith, but I have to respect him as a preacher.
Yes.
And as a businessman for 48 years.
Yes.
He knows Palestine.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And the car was on the table yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Yeah. But I stood tall.
That's all right.
I'm the minister of the Southwest Road Church of Christ in the midst of.
Amen.
Ask them, we will rise.
Amen.
We shall rise.
Amen.
We will stand. We will be known in this community, regardless of what they say.
Amen.
I'm depending on what Jesus said.
Amen.
Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature.
Amen.
He that believeth and is baptized shall
be saved.
Yes, we're going to stand.
Amen.
Yes, there's trouble everywhere, but we are promoting love.
Amen.
In the midst of.
All right.
Everybody not perfect, not even the preacher.
Amen.
But we in the prayers of, we in the hands of a perfect God.
Yes.
Amen, somebody.
Yes.
Church, let's give God the glory.
Yes. Amen.
Today, let's give God the glory.
Amen.
You've heard it, if you're not a Christian, you've heard the gospel. Mm-hmm. All you got to do is believe that gospel, Acts 15 and 7.
Mm-hmm.
Repent of your sins. Luke 13:3, Jesus said, I tell you nay, except you repent. He said, y'all, all, not y'all. He said, all, likewise perish. Then you go down into the water, you be buried. Matthew 10:32, you confess his name. You letting the world and the church know you're not ashamed. I'm tired of struggling. I want some of this. Even in the midst of my struggle, there's freedom and there's joy. You come out by that water, you be a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
You study.
Oh, yes.
You get in here with the rest of us, and we fight this. We fight the characteristic of Satan.
Yes.
That's what, when you learn what the characteristic is,
mm-hmm.
then you know what you're fighting.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But the battle is not ours, it's the Lord.
Amen,
amen, somebody.
Amen.
Wherever you are spiritually,
yes,
you can come and together we stand and sing the Savior's invitation.
Amen.
Amen.